The distinction between state and private surveillance is, to my mind, totally overstated. You know, if you think that you can trust governments because they represent you, but not corporations, or if you think that governments are intrinsically sinister, but at least with corporations, you're trading your information for in exchange for some value, the thing you need to realize is that for so long as corporations are collecting huge amounts of our personal information, that will be an attractive nuisance to governments, and they will go and take that information for them. And for as long as governments view it as proportionate to gather lots of information, they'll never stop corporations from doing it because they can always go to the corporation and get information effectively for free that the companies have already gathered. So to make this distinction between private or public surveillance is, I think, totally wrong. If we're ever going to get corporations to stop spying on us and for governments to hold them to account and audit them and make sure they're doing what they say they're doing and not sneakily spying on us, even though they claim they're not, then we're going to have to end both the state and private practice of surveillance.
Well, this is what's so interesting because we have this moment in history where we're seeing a confluence of both public and private actors essentially rolling out infrastructure in cities for a whole range of purposes. In some cases, as we saw recently in New York, it was an advertising company that set up eye beacons, basically tracking people as they walk through the streets of New York. Now, that's fantastic for an advertiser. You can see where people go over time. That gives you a very detailed picture of people that you might want to sell things to. But at the same time, you have these parallel infrastructures that are in layers on top of those infrastructures. We have camera infrastructures that are both private and public. We have sensor infrastructures that are both private and public. And in some cases, those sensors are actually very benign. They're doing things that we would find very useful, like checking for air quality or looking at general background noise to try and figure out which areas of the city have a noise pollution problem. But then there are ones that are less benign. We have, organizations setting up extremely high-resolution cameras to try and, do particular forms of social science on the city. But none of this is going through a process of debate or of public accountability.